mi nombre es Agustín Soriano, soy trainer formado en Bodensport. Y para mí, bueno, primero dar las gracias a usted por la invitación. Es un honor, por la parte general, tener el honor de estar aquí. Y también por la parte de Forza, ¿no? Es también un placer poder representar a esta agencia tan especial. Vamos a hacer la presentación en inglés, porque Ted no habla español, así que voy a cambiar ahora al inglés. So with me today is Ted Maelstrom, one of the most brilliant art directors we have at Forza Modern Force. And we are going to talk today about two things. The first thing is about how we understand the work culture in the agency, how we are structured, how we work. And the second thing, I would like to explain to you why a Spaniard is freezing his ass up in the north. So if I can explain it to, that to you, I think it's an objective accomplished. So this presentation is in the title of this. It's demo, right? As you have seen in the booklet, this presentation is not approved by anyone. So, and that's true. This title encapsulates really well how we work, how we understand advertising at first and modern force, how we understand empowerment and responsibility. But before going into how we work, we would like to introduce you the kind of work we make at first and modern force with a small show wheel that we have prepared for you today. For over 20 years. We have won over 100 Lions in Cannes, and we have won, I think it's 6 or 7 Grand Prix. Three of those we won the last couple of 3 years. three consecutive ones. Yeah, so I think if there is something that we all have in common, the reason why we go to work every day, the reason why this festival is done, is to make great work, right? So I think, and since we were working in the beginning and we were learning, I think that there were two variables that we thought that were the most important thing for making great work, which is time and talent. So the more you work and the better the talent, the better the outcome, right? But at the agency, we think there is a third variable, which is the context. If you are in a place where you feel empowered, where you feel heard, where you feel that your opinion is making a difference, then you can be the best version of you. You can put your gut feeling, you can put your madness, you can put your brain into making good work. But on the other side, if you're in an environment where you have this cloud of doubt all the time on top of you, where you feel that the rest of the people don't trust in you, then you do shitty work. Then is when you start to work against a square and to please a system. And this is when you start to fail. So this goes for a lot of us. This is important, especially for the owners of advertising agencies or creative directors and so on. It's to, how important it is to secure the place where we work to make people feel great and feel confident. And that's of a great importance for us at Forman & Workforce. And then we have brought today the first case study to exemplify this. This is A2C, which is a sports brand in Sweden. It is owned, among others, by Zlatan Ibrahimovic, which is one of the best football players in the world, and arguably the most famous person in Sweden, maybe.
Yeah.
So it was a pretty big deal for the agency, it was a pretty big deal for Zlatan. And then in the day of the presentation, we presented this script that you're going to see now, and the client was like, yeah, but it's not this so aggressive, but what kind of feelings and thoughts are going to have the female target group of this man? And then the client looked across the table, and on the other side of the table there were two female creatives in their 20s that wrote this script super confident and super proud and really like supported by the rest of the group and the rest of the agency, transmitting that to the client. And the client decided to go along with this, and this is the result.
All right, it will be hard, it will hurt, it will be painful. But giving up is never an option. Don't ever obey the need to stop. Who will fight to the end? I will. There will be doubters, those who say you'll never make it, those who say you don't have the body, the skills, or the talent. Feed on those. Rip out their tongues and let their words be your meat. You will prove them wrong. I will. Go gladly into the lion's den. Make it your battlefield. Leave them bleeding on the ground. Conquer what has not been conquered. Play them. Beat them. Surprise them. Never show weakness. Who will conquer? I will. No one can deny you. No one can defy you. No one can tell you who or what you can be. You write the rules. You will sweat, cry, scream, bleed. Because you will never go home. Never give up. Who will be the champion? I will. No armor will make you stronger, faster, better. Don't fool yourself. Only one thing can take you from A to C. You!
So do we create an environment that enables two very young and unexperienced creatives to not only write the script for this campaign, but also to do it with confidence? What is our manual? It can be broken down into one word. Responsibility. We trust every creative with their own clients. Everyone takes full responsibility. Everyone is in charge, running their own businesses. This is what we don't have. We have no formal hierarchy within the creative departments. We have no CCOs. We have no ECDs. We have no creative directors. 99% of the agencies around the world are run like this, despite the fact that it's a more than 50-year-old method, and we are supposed to be a creative industry. Our crew, on the other hand, looks more like this. We only have creatives. We only have art directors and copywriters. Some are, of course, more union than others. They don't all have the same salary, and they all don't work on kind of big clients. But no one is in charge of other people's work. Let me explain. This is the more traditional way of working within the ad agency, and it has been since the 50s. The best creative is the CEO, and below him are the ECDs and the CDs. They are all very talented, but most of the time they spend on reviewing other people's work. They don't actually do work themselves. But in the bottom part, there are the art directors and copywriters shooting at different briefs, trying to please their bosses and trying to convince their CCOs or ECDs. In our company, the model is upside down. On the top is the creative teams, the art director, the copywriter, the account director, and the planner. And below them are the kind of the supporting functions, sort of such as music supervisors, designers, service functions, finance, etc., etc. And in the bottom is our CEO, Eric, and he pretty much doesn't do anything until we get a problem with a client or if there's something that we need to sort out in a kind of more speedy way, so to speak. So his role is kind of diminished, I would say.
So this is pretty much what we think in the agency. And if you read this sentence, the only boss in the task is itself, it is true. It is the damn truth. So I think this is the first thing that you hear when you join Forceman Bonding Force, is that they tell you, you are the only responsibility you have is to move forward, to push forward the project. And even if you receive a brief for a banner campaign, for instance, for UNICEF, you have two options. You can do actually a banner campaign, or you can do this.
Even so, come Lord Jesus. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. There, that's my story.
You've done so many good things.
Great story.
Yeah, and so long. You're all too kind. Now, Hugo, how did you get here? Tell us everything. I was born in a small suburb outside Stockholm. I had a normal childhood, I guess. Well, I was the middle child, so that was pretty rough at times. And when I graduated from school, I traveled to Australia for a couple months.
Were you kidding, I suppose?
No, just partying, surfing. Well, yeah. So when I got back, I started to look for a job. And I'm still searching. Well, anyway, one day I saw this banner from UNICEF, and it said that I could save children's lives. So I clicked it. And here I am.
Great story.
It's like your entire life led to that single moment when you saved those children.
Guess I'm a late bloomer, huh?
You may be a late bloomer, but when you bloom, you blossom.
Köp dina julklappar på unicef.se och rädda barns liv.
So, when you on the internet,
this is the internet.
Yeah, well, this is one page on the internet, but there are many more.
How many?
Oh, I don't know. Many, many millions.
Oh.
Yeah. So I just move the cursor to the banner and click it.
Wow.
Yeah. Same lives, just like that. You want to try?
Can I?
There you go. That's it. Great. But you picked the wrong banner, though.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Not all banners save lives.
The others are going to love this.
No, what?
Oh, this is the banner he was talking about. It's on an internet, but there are millions of internets, so you have to click the right one.
Yeah, basically.
Fantastic.
Köp dina julklappar på unicef.se och rädda barns liv.
You want to try it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I think
you put it up in the right corner.
Quick now?
Yes. Great! Oh, I did it too! Very good!
So for sure that the question that you are having right now in your heads, like asking all the time, is like, okay, if you don't have any boss or creative director, who makes sure that the world gets featured? Who decides if the world has enough quality to move on and to be presented to the client? And the answer is pretty simple, is the team. So they are empowered to decide whatever it is about regarding the work. So the first one I'm going to force is run by the small core teams that are run like enterprises, the small enterprises within the agency. And they are formed by four or five people, an art director, a copywriter, a business director maybe, always, and then a planner. And sometimes there is as well a PR strategist, but not always, right? So they do pretty much everything. They go to the client, they receive the brief, they come up with the strategy together, they come up with the concept, they write the scripts, they produce the thing, and they have the contact with the client. They are the only ones that have the contact with the client. And they have, as a consequence of that, a really good opinion about where the business of the client is going in 3, 5, 10 years. So they are the ones that decide almost everything. And then we have, since we don't have creative directors, we have this, which is the floor. It's the place where we show the work that we do to the others. So at Forman & Bonnet Force, it's expected that you show the work that you're working on to the others. So you print out what you are working on and then you put it on the floor and you invite people there to receive feedback, opinions from them. And it's pretty tough because it's work in progress. And it's like, it's gonna be judged from the others, right? But it's the way that it's supposed to be. And then as well, that you are expected to show the work, you are expected to help others as well. So it doesn't matter the amount of work you have in that day, how stressed you are. If someone comes to your place and asks, hey mate, could you come here? I would love to hear your opinion or your feedback about this. You have to leave your work behind and go there and start a conversation. Maybe 20 minutes, 30 minutes to talk about what is on the floor, right? And we do this pretty much in every stage, in every phase of the work. So we do it with the strategy. So when I'm working with the strategy, and the thoughts are put on the floor, and I invite people. And that's the trick, right? Because you are more afraid, I'm more afraid of the opinions of my colleagues than the opinion of the client, because the colleagues, I mean, they know where the tricks are, and you are making a jump there, or an assumption here. So it's pretty tough, right? And we do this as well with
create with concepts, with scripts, with even offline edits, and we invite people. But again, it's up to you, it's up to the team to get that feedback in or not. So they decide what to do with that.
And for example, when we made the Epic Split, a very senior, prominent partner at the agency thought that the Enya music sucked. He thought it was terrible and that we should change the music on the Epic Split. But the core team kind of stuck to their beliefs and didn't change the music at all. And it turned out pretty nice anyway. So, but I'm not quite sure what to say. The partner thought about the music on the next piece you're about to see, but he probably has something to say about the music. One more.
I'm gonna walk up. Then I stop there, then I drive it. Left and right. Back and forth.
I think the beauty of this way of working allows people or allows the groups to have creatives that are behaving like business directors or business directors that are behaving like creatives. So, for instance, have a business director that is able to talk about creativity, about concepts, to defend those concepts against the client, right? Or with the client. And then creatives that are really comfortable talking about money or talking about business objectives, right? And this is a really good way for the people that in the agency to grow exponentially, to grow really, really, really fast. And then for me, for instance, as a planner, when I joined Force Management, they told me, man, I mean, relax. You don't have to create the strategy by yourself. You have the team to do that. So be sure that the team is thinking as planners. So instead of having just one guy working in the strategy and trying to crack the strategy, you have 5 billion people putting their heads into solving the problem. As a consequence of that, we don't have any kind of departments, or we are working in this kind of flat place where everyone is mixed. The CEO even sits next to a copywriter or a junior producer or something like that. So we are all mixed to encourage these conversations and to make people with different profiles exchange experiences and talk from different point of views. And this is as well quite mind-blowing, especially with the way we work in Spain. We don't have fixed creative teams or parejas, couples. So for instance, Ted is working as an art director with a copywriter with one client, then he's working with another copywriter for another client, and another copywriter for another client. So there are no fixed creative teams. Because we believe that you don't have to put your career and rely your career on one single person, because you are going to start thinking as he's thinking and vice versa, right? So it is better to take experience and different point of views from all the people that is in the agency. That way you can grow faster, and most importantly, we can avoid the competition between creative teams. That's as well really important. The next case study we're going to see now, it was done by a copywriter and a director, and it was the first time that they worked together. And according to the result, it worked pretty well.
Wear brown shoes after 6. Wear a hat indoors. Wear a short skirt after 40. Wear a short skirt if you're a man. Try too hard. Don't try at all. Dress like a girl. Dress like a man. Dress like a teen. Stand out. Blend in. Mix prints. Mix pink and red. Show your panty line. Go commando. Cut her up. Show it all. Be trashy. Be neat. Wear pink. Wear blue. Wear yellow if you're blonde. Wear red if you're a redhead. Wear socks and sandals. Look fake. Look chic. Look shake. Be a princess. Be boring. Take a stand. Be uniform. Be liberated. Be old. Be new. There are no rules in fashion but one. Recycle your clothes.
Sometimes very, very demanding. First of all, you need to leave prestige aside. You must dare to show ideas that are not yet finished, even ideas that you may doubt yourself. And it can be hard. Most of us want to prove ourselves. You have to show your colleagues what you're working on.
Showing work in progress ideas can be both intimidating and uncomfortable, especially to people that you admire. You have to listen to critique. It doesn't matter if you're a 50-year-old copywriter who has won 4 Grand Prix in Cannes, you still have to listen to what your 25-year-old newly recruited art director has to say, because she might be right, you know. And you have to engage in other people's work and speak your mind. You have to give your honest opinion on other people's work, even to people who are 20 years your senior and may have been the people that hired you. And this is pretty much one of the most important ones. You have to learn. You have to learn to talk for your ideas. You have to learn to stay clear from compromise. And you have to learn from other people's experiences and benefit from them. And you have to be prepared to change your mind. You don't have to, but you have to be prepared to do it. But you're still in charge, though. But if you can do all these things, you will realize the beauty in this system. Everyone is there to help you. No one will think that you're an idiot if you come up with a bad idea or a bad concept or get stuck in the process, because that's what we all do. We come up with bad ideas and then we navigate around them until we find a good one. And the fun thing about this is if you do award-winning work and if you win a lot of awards, you will of course take the credit. But somehow the rest of the agency and the people that have helped you along the way will feel somehow proud and involved in the process. And if you do something not that great, you will still have the agency behind you.
Yeah, so there is a fine balance between being elitist with the work you do and being nice with people. And I think at the agency we want to be 100% both, right? So we want to make world-class work, and we want to be human, we want to be nice with everyone. And I think the combination of that is really difficult, but I think we have reached a point where we have it at the front moment for us, and I think the next this study is the result of that, of the balance between being really, really demanding of the work that we do and being nice with
everyone.
你一天不结婚，父亲就不死。不要任性，可怜天下父母，抽来抽去的，多个女人，都应该结婚。你现在已经是剩女了。剩女这个词给人的感觉就是剩下来的女人。给我的感觉就是说，即使好像25岁以后还不结婚，就是剩女了。
可能会被别人说，或者被家人催，或者有些社会的压力吧。所以，顾林回家是压力最大的。我全部人都会在问你：“你都多大了，还没结婚呢？”
你年龄也不小啦。
他们就可能觉得，就是在中国这个社会，就是一定要结婚，那才是一个完整的女人。
你还在城外的感觉。以前拉对象，那就。
人家已经结婚了。我个人认为我不太喜欢人民广场的相亲角，然后可能都是父母，然后拿了一个女儿或者儿子的介绍，然后放在那边。收入啊，工作是什么样子的？有没有房子？有没有车子？挂个招商启事给卖出去是那种。中国中华儿女嘛，就是孝子为当先。
因为反正就不结婚，肯定是不孝的一种。以前我总认为我的女儿肯定性格好嘛，人也不是长得太漂亮，一般嘛，所以到现在还是剩下了。渴望真爱，
对我还是很渴望爱情。赶快把它解决好了算了，
你不要太残忍了，对吗？
也许。
想要放弃找个最喜欢的、适合的也挺好。你说要真正找不着，也是我们老两口一个心病。
可能这方面我比较自私，我想跟他说对不起。<笑>
然后我希望我这样的一个状态非常能够得到父母的认可。现在有女强人吗？这么一说的话，
直到等到那个对的人，妈妈永远支持。
对于自己生活这件事，我是很开心的，然后很自由，我也享受一个人的状态。
我女儿很美，
圣女很光荣啊。
独立
着也应该活得很精彩的，这就是我想。
他如果觉得单身的也蛮好，我们还是会尊重他。
是优秀的女孩啊，向来要努力啊。
自信，独立，热爱生活，不错的一位女性。
Thank you.